What's going on, guys? This is the MacDuck Toby here, second to none custom. Like always, a pleasure to have you back. I know it's been a minute. I apologize. Things have been a little bit slow, busy, a little bit of everything. And yeah, right now we're down to two builds in the channel. We got the RX7, the 84 GSLSC, and we got the new track SIEG hatch. You already know. So I'm definitely picking back up on that. You know what I mean? Sort of been a little bit slacking, but we'll go through that. So with our friend waiting, we're gonna get to today's block. We're gonna try to do coilovers on the hatch. I got some coilover sleeves. I'm gonna try to teach you pretty much, guys, you know, show you how to install them real quick, you know what I mean? Then the hardest thing in the world, but we're gonna get to it. I'm definitely excited to get to the suspension and a couple other things that we getting coming up soon. So without further ado, stay through it. First, we're gonna start loosening up the BMS rims. Today, I'm doing partial coilover sleeves install on it. I got rear control subframe bar coming up, and I also got the control arms for the rear that are going to start as well. So, I'm gonna try to cover all in once. Pause.
Thank you.
here. Start removing the wheels. So I'll take out my lock and lock nut, if you want to call them. I want to say what's up to everybody coming into the channel. Yeah, they are new. Thank you for the subscribing, for liking and commenting in the channel. We almost had 100 subs. Please subscribe, like, comment, and share. And yeah, we're going to be doing a 100 giveaway t-shirt pretty soon. As soon as we hit 100. And then from there, we're going to do another giveaway once we reach 500. I'm going to do like a $100 giveaway card to a subscriber. But for now, let's get to today's topic. And yeah, we got that one off. Sweet. We took the tire out. And we got 1, 2, 3 screws, 14 millimeters. This one is broken loose. Pretty much, I just leaving it there in place for right now. This one, however, Houston, we got a problem. Snapped. So I do not want to make this video about covering anything in any install. So I want to make this so that we could all comprehend, and if we have the same situation at home, that we could take care of it. Right now, I thought I could tap this screw in, and that'll push through the other side. Probably fall down. Nope, that's not happening. So what I'm gonna have to do is get my grinding disc, get my grinder ready. I'm gonna try to slice it here, slice it through the other side, pull it down, and once we get through that stage, remember the control arm is garbage pretty much. I got new ones coming on aluminum, ones coming out maybe tomorrow, the next day. So since the new ones are coming in, I might as well get these out. By all means, we just need pretty much this, the coil oil strut, and yeah, I get myself prepped with the grinder and we see how things get looking like. All right, getting ready to cut that bolt down. Got a angle grinder to do it. You guys use this. Please wear a respirator mask and the right safety precautions, eye goggles and stuff like that. Take your time. Nobody's trying to be the hero, you know what I mean? But we're gonna get to this snap screw in the lower control arm because we need to remove it in order to put the coil. And I got new control arms, aluminum ones that are coming, so they have to get removed. All right, stay tuned. To cut it right, but I realized I don't want to cut through and have to come down, so I'm gonna get a jack safety or something down with the snap if it comes down a little bit. And by the way, I'm gonna check about halfway through on this side, so a little bit more, and get rid of that freaking bolt. Hands on for a minute. So we on the other side now. This one is already ours. You already seen this one. Before I even touched it, somebody snapped it. So I got the same problem that I had over there. The only issue I got here in this side is spinning on the other side when I'm taking out this bolt. If it wasn't for that, I could just drop this bolt, loosen that bolt, the two on tops, and I could just drop this and cut it off like I did to that side. So yeah, it's been a little bit of a pain in the ass, so I'm gonna do a little maneuvering and I'll show you guys. Hopefully I have it out. Stay tuned. Yep. So it's now the next day. Like now it was like 9:30 and change when we removed them puppies out. It took forever. Had to do a little cutting bolts here and there. We got them out, cleaned up. Also another thing that I went and did off camera. I don't look like much, but it looked pretty clean. Also did the bottom. Yeah. Nice and undecoated, nice and clean. That way when we put our coils, subframe, tie bar, and also the control arms, everything is gonna be nice and clean. Peeps, this is how crazy the weather is over here. We'll just maggot. But can't complain. Like the first one of the season. Oh well, this is no hell. Oh, back to our regular program. I'm so happy every time I get open boxes and shit. Could be the smallest thing, even if it was used. But something about opening packages. Must be a kit thing. Kind of like when you wait for Christmas, they wrap that present and stuff, you know, you get all hyper up. And not realizing all the time your parents spent wrapping it up just to throw up in 30 seconds. And I wonder how long they took, or what it took them to get that paper just to wrap it for you, not to mention the present. But that's just life, the little things that we enjoy. Those are like good memories that I have with my mom. You know, she's always been there for me. If you're watching, love you, mother. And yeah, let's get to it. Run out of packaging here. I swear, these companies all the time, never a single sticker. But, side, happy. Got damage over here. Bastards. Yep. Monetize. So, yeah. Get to the hypeness and see what we got here. The subframe board. Come with the hardware that is installed, which we're gonna get to. Now we're gonna get to the second box. With the hardware. Trying to keep everything separate, pause. There's no parts and then blame it on freaking eBay. It's all good, it's all off. Alright, kind of hard to do one handed. The second pour. There's hardware. I believe these are from here. Seems like chimps. Something not to scratch them. Now, we go to the best pour. Now the box. Believe the new coil set. Excuse me. Lower Bart. And our box right here is our lower control arms. New retain low bushings. high pottage all the way around, all the hardware for the subframe tie bar and everything. So yeah, just wanted to give you a peeps on everything. That's pretty much gonna cover the hole underneath it while we do everything in a few. This is the old coils, excuse me, all struts. We're getting rid of that, doing the coil installments. Of course, that BMS wheels removed. Love them shits. Like I told you already, on the coated this yesterday. These, I'm not worried about it because I'm getting new this. Everything here brand new pretty much when it comes up with the brakes at the end, so I'm not worried about that. I just needed to clean this because once I install the coils and everything else, something tight bar that's gonna be installed for a minute, so it have nothing to do with the brakes, of course. But yeah. So I'm starting to looking good, tight up. You know, like I said, down to minor things, the hatch, important things, big things when it comes down to money. I ain't gonna front, you know what I mean? So right now I gotta wait up till my money is right so I could get some of the things. But every time I could put something into her, hook it up, do the best. You know what I mean? It's going into her. So, yeah. Let me get to this coil real quick. What I'm going to do, I'm going to happen do one. And then I'll show you one. The second set. As I do it. And then we do on the front same. Vice versa. Alright. So, we got one of the control arms already on. I got the other side on. Now I'm putting the subframe tie bar. Sorry, I didn't tape the whole process, taking it off, putting it on. You know, I've been struggling here for a minute. And if I finish it the right way, it'll be like an hour and a half video. Y'all won't watch it. So, right now, I gotta get this screw out so I can put my traction bar, tie bar up. Already did one of the coils already. It's already installed, so I'll show you, and I'll show you guys how I did, how I do the other side at least. So, sorry about the clanking and ranking. We'll get these out. It's only a hair. There you go. Put the boy over here. Put him in his place. Give me a second. Yes, have to do on camera a little bit. After I did one, I took it out again, and my phone died a little bit. I couldn't do the process of showing you guys how I convert it. But this is already set. We got our coils in there. It's a matter of just getting them installed into the hatch. Show you guys how the subframe look already, and yeah. Good money. This is how we're looking down here. Check out the ice. Check out the ice. Nice and fresh. On the core all that yesterday. Still gotta do a little work underneath here tomorrow. I gotta remove the gas tank. Cause I got a fuel cell. That way that's not gonna help. But underneath here we're looking good. That's already on. Gotta throw my struts real quick, and we'll see how things are looking. Look. Gotta make sure when you put the struts, put it with the numbers facing this way, that way when you adjust your coil, it's easier to match up and measure your alignment. Slowly release my jack. Bring my bottle a little bit. Nice and slowly. We gotta gasket. I made sure it's sealed. Pretty much tight. I'll go to the top. Tie in my two bolts. We're gonna get to put the 214s from the top. I got a brace bar for the top. I was not installed before, so I'm gonna do it now. I wanted to wait till all these was done. I'm gonna take it in, take it out. Not a server purpose. I recommend use a socket for this better. I'm using a wrench for the time being. Kind of a lazy mode is what I have at hand right now. Not necessary, I don't have the tools. I got plenty. All around the hatch and the floor, as a matter of fact. Just a matter of right now at hand. The wrench is what I have. Gonna hand tie them real good and we'll come back and torque them. Whatever it takes, should be pretty tight. Now we go to the other side. I will repeat the same process for the passenger side. I got a jacket under the frame. Move jacks, and I should have enough space to put the bottle now. Be good money. Once again, number facing this way, that we could get the right measuring and high adjustment when we need to. Lining up my holes, right on place, and that's good money. Loosen the jack, that way, there you go. Go tie the 214s on top. I'm gonna tie the 14s on the passenger side. This time I went in I grabbed myself a socket so that we could tie this to the right spec. I hand tie them first, and then we'll tie it up with the torque ratchet. Switch, don't want to strip, so
switch them up. See if it'll work better on this side. Good impact wrench will come handy, but boy, it's kind of tight right now. $300-$400 for an impact wrench. Crazy. Alright, so that's tight. Do the other side while I'm here. Finishing up this 14 on this lower control arm, and this should be it. Sometimes I help put the jack underneath the arm itself, so it could help the screw line up. If you get the right thread, now you be just spinning and spinning, might potentially hurt the thread. We all tie it up now. Got one more screw to put in here. And we should be good. How everything looking? We're already installed. Tied up. Gotta pull my tire. Put the jack back on. Take the stance out. See how it looks. Alright, quick look on both sides. They're already installed. And the passenger side, we're already on. So yeah, we got money. Here's the other tool for the front, which won't be able to cover in this video because it took a little bit too long. So, yeah, pretty much is the same process from the back to the front.
By the way, I borrowed this tool for my boy. They are spring compressors, if you want to call them. They take the compression on the coil itself, shrinks it so you can take it out. It's not going to harm yourself. Then you can release it and put it back on, etc. This is the part that I couldn't cord because my phone died. So I apologize. But yeah, everything's looking good. I'm going to throw on the rims real quick, see how it looks. This is how low she's sitting. When I first dropped it, it was mellow. I couldn't even get the jack out. But yeah, she's already on the ground on her rims. Everything's tall. She's looking good. That's the perfect height for me. Because I still got to drop the front. And when I drop the front, I'm going to incline a little bit. But yeah, I couldn't ask for better, man. Come out super dope. Oh, three and a half inches different, probably 4 inches. It was super high in the back. So it's like a perfect there. Yeah, I like it. Now we'll do the passenger side. Same thing. Perfect. Because they have some floor clearance. That's good. Yeah, she look a little dusty. She's been saying. Yeah. That's it. She looks sick. Look at how low the back. Like, compared to me now. It's like to my chest high now. Just the back. That's just perfect. But yeah, she's looking great. Alright guys, yeah, I want to thank every single one of you at home for liking, commenting, staying in tune. Now, till next time, peace.